The end could be near for the dock dispute on the West Coast. Negotiators have agreed to a tentative contract covering the dock workers. This comes after 9 months of negotiations, which turned sour when the last contract expired in July. The dispute has led to congestion at the docks and delays in shipments to areas including Hawaii. Nestor Garcia continues his coverage of the dock dispute and has an update. Ness?
Joe, the Labor Secretary had warned the two sides that if the settlement was not reached tonight, he would have them both resume contract talks in Washington, D.C. The last contract expired in June, as you said, Joe, and the talks dragged on and then went off and on as each side blamed the other for the congestion at the West Coast ports. The congestion triggered delays of shipments, especially with goods that were shipped from Asia and made their way to either of the 29 docks from Seattle to San Diego. It's estimated the delays cost retailers about $7 billion. KHON2 reported on how the delays force companies here to scramble to meet the demands of their customers. The dispute centered on pay, including pension benefits, as well as on how to hire and fire an arbitrator to settle labor disputes. The breakthrough occurred when President Obama sent in Labor Secretary Thomas Perez to bring the two sides together.
Well, I'll leave that to the parties to discuss how the arbitration issue, the arbitrator issue was resolved. The collective bargaining process was the way it was resolved. I was very clear to them that as the Labor Secretary, I was neutral on how they resolved that issue, but I wasn't neutral on how fast they resolved that issue. It needed to be resolved immediately, and the parties were able to do that.
Now, both sides praised the involvement of the Labor Secretary, as you heard, as well as a federal mediator that was also on hand to bring on the settlement. Now, the new 5-year contract still needs to be approved by the rank-and-file members of both management and the ILWU. And I will continue to follow up on the dock dispute and will report the very latest on air and online at khon2.com.